Well, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to this very exciting event.
Fast-tracking the Future is Sydney Metro's school education program, and it provides, as we've said, syllabus-aligned experiences from kindergarten to year 10.
First of all, we want to increase the teacher capacity to be able to teach through inquiry-based practices. Then we want to engage students more in the curriculum. And so using Sydney Metro is really effective because it's a context that students know about, it's in their own backyards, it has real meaning when we connect the Sydney Metro ideas to the school curriculum. And the other benefit, I guess, is that we increase people's knowledge about Sydney Metro and what's happening in their communities.
Our entire school population has been involved, all the staff, all of the students. Have been involved.
What I saw in the classroom was that students were busy, they were working in their teams. It really does mimic working in industry where employers are working in teams, setting goals and meeting deadlines and getting along with each other.
We're very excited because we've just published a research report from this project, our second one, and literally it's hot off the press. We launched the first program in 2018, where we had three cohorts of teachers who undertook the professional learning program. In 2019, we actually analysed the research data that we collected along the way and published our first report. In 2020, we actually got a commendation from the planning industry for an award for cutting edge research and teaching. And in 2021, we actually published an academic journal article looking at student engagement as a result of that collaboration between industry experts, the university and teachers. So the knowledge is being created and it's getting out there. And then we actually launched in 2021 and 22 the second iteration of the program, where we've had three cohorts and we have our new research report, which we're very, very proud of.
Inquiry-based learning for the kids creates a context that's actually relevant to them, so they can see how they could apply their learning to their real world and how it can help them with their employment in the future. It affects their everyday life, it affects how they get to school, how their parents get to work, so it really does hit home with them, that kind of learning.
The main reason why we chose Tavistation is because it looks very aesthetically good. It focuses like a real metro, how it's supposed to look. It's underground, ground level, and above ground level. So overall, it's a very, very normal metro.
Inquiry-based learning is really engaging for the teachers as well. It gives us a where to for our students. It allows us to learn alongside them and really tailor the learning to their point of need at that time. It was really interesting to see how we sometimes started in one point as teachers, and the students led us to a completely different path than, I guess, where we thought we would end up in our unit. It really allowed the students to tailor the learning to what they were interested in, and it took us to places we never expected.
Look, it's much more engaging for students to be talking about a real life project like Sydney Metro. Just trying to make something up is not the same. So when you're being asked a question about a real life project, you can really imagine the trains, the stations, and you can really come up with some great solutions.
Sydney Metro is such a rich project that touches on the way that we live. It actually hits any curriculum area, so it's very easy to fit into that inquiry-based learning process.
I would absolutely endorse and celebrate and promote and inspire other schools to get involved, because being able to be in something as authentic and related to their community gets students turning up every day, gets them excited about learning, and gives principals, teachers and the collective school community a real buzz about what they do each day.